In the first part of this video, we looked at the fun theories behind the etymology of gringo. Now I'm moving on to the modern use of the word. Specifically, how gringo can be used to describe someone's appearance, fashion sense, ethnicity, and immigration status. Plus, how the word can be used as an insult or be entirely inoffensive while also describing food. Gringo has many connotations, but at its most basic, it's used to describe an American, and usually one who's hanging out in Latin America. Some people will say that Europeans and Canadians are also gringos, while others will strongly disagree. In Brazil, it simply means foreigner, and even other people from Latin America are called gringos, regardless of their appearance. Which leads us to our next observation. Todos le dicen el gringo, aunque eres de Culiacán. Even if they're born and raised in Latin America, any Caucasian-looking or white-passing person will often be told that they look like gringos. In this example, being called a gringo obviously refers to a person's physical appearance, but it can also extend to their fashion sense. Wearing cargo shorts and flip-flops is a dead giveaway that you dress like a gringo, but that you also don't respect yourself. And he's just another gringo in Belize. Absolutely. Check out the comment section of any travel blog or even mainstream news site, and you'll quickly come across angry comments by Americans who hate the word and even consider it racist. There's no long history of racism against white people, so calling the word racist seems a bit ludicrous. But depending on the use and the inflection, it can certainly be offensive. And that's because gringo can be synonymous with entitlement. For example, if a spring breaker goes to Cancun and throws up on the street, a local passerby might say, "That's just a gringo being a gringo." The word can also be used to insult other Latinos, specifically the ones who don't speak Spanish, or weren't born or fully raised in Latin America, or if they don't partake in their culture. Aida Ramirez laid out two examples in an article for NPR, which reads, "I may have been born in Guatemala, but I was raised in Florida. Regardless of the fact that I have lived in the US since I was 2 years old, most Americans would find it strange to hear my grandma occasionally calls me media gringa, a half gringa." In the same article, Aida also wrote, "My mother and I call my brother a gringo because he doesn't eat gallo pinto, the traditional Nicaraguan dish of rice and beans. When he complains about a meal, we say, ese se cree gringo, he thinks he's a gringo." As I mentioned earlier, the word serves a practical function, which is to differentiate between the things that Latinos think are weird about Americans and the often even weirder things that Latinos think are normal. For example, if I was invited to an American birthday party and after blowing out the candles, I started chanting mordida, mordida, while also trying to shove the birthday person's face into their own cake, my mom would probably intervene and say, "No, son, gringos don't like their cake with traces of eyelashes, boogers, and saliva." And I would be like, "Oh, how strange, mom, because traces of human face is what gives cake that extra salty taste that we all appear to love in Latin America. Otherwise, why are we shoving people's faces in cakes?" Case in point, under that example, no offense would be meant while using the word gringo. Speaking of food, tacos, enchiladas, and beans. In Mexico, a gringa can be any taco or quesadilla that is served on a flour tortilla instead of the classic corn tortilla. According to myth, two gringas were studying Spanish in Mexico City, where they would frequent a local taqueria and request to swap in tortillas. Since they preferred the taste of flour instead of corn, henceforth, taqueros started calling those types of tacos and quesadillas gringas. Gabacho is mostly used in Mexico and Central America, but it can be used as a synonym for gringo and also all of the US. So if I said, "Me mudo al gabacho," it would translate into, "Let me stock up on cargo shorts and flip-flops because I'm moving to America." If you like this kind of content, check out the Americano on social media for more. Adios gringos peleoneros, buenos pa' las guerras son. Ellos creen que Dios es blanco y es más moreno que yo.